Hello, everybody. I seem to have been talking into the void until now. Can everybody hear me now? I just went and turned on the microphone. Hopefully you can hear me now. So just acknowledge in the chat if I am now audible. In the meantime, I am going to keep playing. Ooh, fog ghouls. There we go. Yeah, so I'm using this new... I'm using OBS Studio now. Like, previously I just used regular OBS. And so I've had to, like, go and redo the settings and everything. And the UI is a little different than regular OBS. So I was just like... So I thought I had turned on the Yeti mic, but apparently I hadn't. So now it's on. We're all like all good. I'm loud and clear. Awesome. The game audio is hopefully okay too. It's funny, like I was sitting here talking, promoting From Us to You, like talking about Fallout 4. And I'm just like, wow, the chat's being awfully quiet today. I wonder, like nobody seems to be acknowledging me. I'm such a doofus. Anyway. So yeah, so this is Far Harbor. And as I was saying earlier, there's like this fog and like monsters come out of the fog. It's very Stephen King in that regard. And I am on the way to a synth settlement with this guy named Longfellow. And I don't know, we're gonna like rescue this girl who thinks she might be a synth. So, one thing I'm immediately noticing, so I'm playing on the PlayStation 4 version. Frame rate's definitely dipping with this fog, which is too bad. It makes me want to play the PC version, but not really an option, unfortunately, because I did the review of this, and you can go find our review of it over on... on the website, yes, US Gamer, which is the place that I work. And when they sent out review copies, they sent out the PlayStation 4 version, and I would have had to wait a couple days to get the PC version. And so, even though I really wanted the PC version, I went with the console version. And as a result, I pretty much have to roll with what they give me and roll with it because I can't transfer my save over to the PC version. And I'm not super interested in starting over a 100-hour RPG. That's accurate. In real life, Maine also has a bad frame rate. Now that's funny. Yes, I am laughing. I've never been to Maine. All I know about Maine, for the most part, is lobsters, and Stephen King, and sometimes dead is better. Like that accent, apparently. Oh, and there's that one governor. Maine seems to have an interesting governor, and interesting people. I didn't really get to explore the East Coast until 2014. I mean, I grew up in the Midwest, and when we went on vacation, we went to California, where it was warm. We didn't go to, oh, what is this thing? Oh, did I miss? Nice, great. Are you running away from me? Come back here. I want to be friends. By the way, I have a rad harpoon rifle that I just bought. It's pretty rad. Jeez. Okay, Maybe I should use the Spectre instead. This is my energy rifle. Okay. Maybe I should have talked to it. Maybe I wasn't supposed to kill it. Because boy, it sure didn't do much, did it? Ooh, a workshop. Can I colonize this area? Can I build a settlement? Because it sure looks like I can build a settlement here. Yeah, this definitely looks like settlement material. There's a workshop here. Let's see if it'll let me access the workshop. I don't remember how to do that though. Maybe I have to plant a flag or something. It's a little water thing right here. Can look out over the ocean. That's kind of cool. I don't know why I would set up a settlement in Far Harbor outside of the, you know, the novelty, but. I might go to Maine someday. There's like resort towns and stuff there, I think, right? Anyway. Okay, back to Far Harbor, I guess. I hope everybody's having a good day, by the way. I've had a productive day, I would say. I'm in the middle of a article about Fallout 4's DLC so far. I think it's been a pretty solid run, all things considered. Far Harbor is definitely the most interesting of it. I like the robot DLC, mostly because it gave you a new quest and also gave you an interesting new mechanic in being able to build robots. I'm totally okay with that. Wasteland Workshop, a little bit worse. But
you eyeing me, man?
No, I'm not eyeing you, Harbor Woman.
Odd times.
Oh, it's you. Did I already?
You give that fog crawler what for?
Oh.
Courtesy of the Daltons.
Grandpa George can rest in peace.
I did the side quest by mistake.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger I hoped you were. With that fog crawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the
place. Oh, there. That's how I get my settlement.
The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Why, thank you.
Who else needs to be avenged?
I was just about to.
Yes, I want to kill more people.
Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong. As strong as any a person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
She's had some hard luck.
You were married. What happened?
My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mole rats. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
Sure, why not?
I'll make that trapper pay.
All right, then. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.
Back to the harpoon. The Admiral's friend. And now I'll go do the main quest. Okay, so now I'm gonna go join Longfellow, which I was originally going to do anyway. If you're not wearing power armor, by the way, the radiation here can get a little gnarly. So it's kind of good to have power armor ready for you. Right, Point Lookout. Wasn't that Fallout 3 DLC? That's what I remember it being. Here we go. Sorry, Longfellow.
Hey there.
God, the frame rate. Is not good, Precious. Poor puppy. I like the harpoon gun.
You grow everything extra meat on the island. Still got a ways to go.
On we go. Through the fog. It's nice to have.
They usually stick to the deep fog. Lest we steer.
I think I killed one of those just now. He died pretty good.
When I was a young lad, no higher than your knee.
Apparently you were supposed to go to the Fog Harbor when you're like level 15 or something. But I'm kind of twice that level, so not a big deal, I suppose. Just doing it for the content. Chance to revisit Fallout 4. I don't think the fog is doing this version any, doing the console version any favors.
We ain't alone. Look sharp.
Ah, here we go. Are they fighting each other?
Small gopher, like the ones in these parts, is a fair challenge. Now the big ones, they can grow 2-3 times the size of a man. Good thing you don't see too many of them around.
We playing hide and seek?
You dead. Apparently he ate a desk fan? Okay. Well, I could use the screws, I guess. Don't really need gulper innards. Onward, Longfellow. Yeah, you would think that, vodka, you would think that there, with all this fog, that there would be have better frame rate, but apparently all this filter is like really mess things up. Just too bad. I'm not a fan of the general aesthetic, fog aesthetic. Maybe it's because I live in San Francisco, I don't need all this fog. Good Longfellow? Okay. Oh, these guys. I hate these guys.
Stringing one more soul to their damnation, old man.
Well, what have we here? Another rad worshiping lunatic. That's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against.
Hey,
those
J-Bobo.
Two?
We actually did Solaris a couple days ago, but you can still find the stream on the site. You can watch that.
Who's she?
One of them children of Adam preachers started off as pests. Now they're more like a menace.
Can I have her jacket?
Do not sully.
I don't want your jacket. Also, your hair's gross.
You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
What's Acadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fog. You'd do well to avoid such
holy
creatures.
Fog. Ugh.
Instead, seek the only true master of
I look forward life. To getting rid of the holy fog.
All right, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children. And you may join our family if he deems you worthy.
No, I'd rather not.
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed,
yeah, gross.
You will be rewarded with
everything. And then I can look just like you.
On second thought, I'm good.
So be it. But I would be mindful where you step. After all, you are in Adam's kingdom now.
If you're done wasting time with a fanatic, let's move on.
I'm sure there's a very interesting quest involved there, but yeah, I don't need to be all gross like you. I'm betting that quest ends with me wiping out Far Harbor or whatever, so that Adam's holy fog can continue. But I like my frame rate. Oh look, the frame rate's back.
And we've arrived. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with her, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again.
Oh, Longfellow can be a companion.
Just outside of Far Harbor. Good place to tool up your gear. Get some rest. Or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you're bringing a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
But, I have a more important question. Can I have your jacket? Because your jacket is cool.
Don't you want to see what happens next?
You saying you want me to stick around and watch your back?
Can I have a jacket?
You should come with me. I can still use your help.
All right. Why the hell not? Beats drinking alone.
Sorry, Nick. It's been fun. We're going to send you back. Red Rocket Truck Stop is my home base. Wait. Actually, no, I need to take
just
your gun.
To trade a little.
Yeah, sure thing.
Let's see. Oh, yeah, the Deathclaw hand. It's got laser rifles. Oh, this thing. Which is pretty awesome, actually. But I don't have enough shells. Oh, wow. Is he out of 45 rounds already? Oh, I'm out of 45 rounds. Well, I'll take this. I'll take this, and I will give it to you.
Heads up.
I'm listening. Here's my kit.
There you go. All right, let's do this thing, Longfellow. Yeah, I'm not the kind of person to just go out and murder people, though. And I actually have a pretty sweet jacket already. You can't see it in my power armor, unfortunately, but I like my current outfit, so Longfellow gets to live for now. Pack mules with dialogue, that's a good way to put it. And side quests.
You know, when I first climbed this mountain above the fog, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of clarity, understanding, peace. While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
Okay.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind
like your electrode
of
thingies
had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe.
Actually, I should have brought Nick with me just to see what he would say to being in this place.
Before you do that,
oh well.
Tell me, you think Kasumi is a synth?
Who or what she is isn't important.
But it is. It's everything. Imagine just looking at your own hands and having to wonder, was I born with these, or were they manufactured? None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie, that someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
I'm actually kind of curious to know how...
How would I even know?
I'm afraid if you're looking for some biological test we can do, there isn't any. None that aren't.
I wonder if I can just self-identify.
Instead, you have to look for the signs. Holes in someone's memory. Feelings of unexplained isolation. Odd dreams. But ultimately, you have to decide for yourself. What do you believe? Have you ever questioned your humanity?
Are you a furry?
I'm a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
The first memory?
I remember being in my house the day the bombs fell. We ran to the vault. We were frozen.
Aren't they going to tell me I'm actually a synth?
No memories before then. Just a single day, and then waking up alone. We so easily accept what's presented to us as the truth, don't we? Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation, the They all take their toll on the mine. But I can promise you that we will accept you.
Oh, that's nice.
No matter what you decide you are.
Thank you. You've given me a lot to think about.
I'm glad to hear it. Acadia is open to you. And I'm sure you're eager to talk to Kasumi.
I'm part of a group that helps since. A railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide. Yes, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost, I know how frightening it is, the risk of capture, but sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life?
Ideals aren't going to protect escaped synths. We do what we have to.
I know that's what you think. I just... No. No, I shouldn't judge. I'm over here, far from the Commonwealth, in relative safety. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
I should get going.
Of course.
Well, that was an interesting conversation.
Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
What? Who are we talking? Who's talking to me? Where's Faraday? Are you Faraday? Oh, you must be Faraday.
It's hard enough time keeping up with repairs before all this nonsense with the atom lunatics.
I wonder what would have happened if I had self-identified as synth. I didn't really want to do it because, like, I don't know, I don't want to mess up my playthrough or whatever, and I don't particularly feel like self-identifying as a synth, but he probably would have been like, oh, sweet, you're a synth. And that would have been that? I don't know. Can I get down here? Is there a stairway? It must be a stairway. Well, I will have the synth people know that I self-identify as a unicorn, half unicorn, half dragon.
Ugh, circuitry is completely fried.
Kasumi Nakano?
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of...
Oh, congratulations, JBobo89. Beating Dark Souls is no easy feat.
I'm a detective. I was hired to find you.
You're a what? You came all this way... for me?
Went to some trouble, in fact. Took a walk through the fog to find you.
Look, my mom and dad... I mean, those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back.
What do you mean?
I'm not their daughter. I'm a synth. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
You haven't replaced anyone. Kenji and Rei are still your parents.
I really wish that was true. If I wasn't a synth, things would be so much simpler. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on.
Ooh, dark secrets.
But I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running long enough.
What kind of problem is there in Acadia?
It's a long story. I just have to figure out how to... Wait. Wait, you find things. Track down answers. That's what you do, right?
Yeah, in a manner of speaking.
That's why you came after me.
Sort of.
What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret here, on this island.
Ooh, big secrets.
Something way more important than just one lost girl.
All right. I'm listening.
Okay. Where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dima's hooked up to, right? They hold his memories, or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both? Well... Faraday asked me to.
I wish I had the time to finish Dark Souls 3. You know, I'm in Ithril of the Boreal Valley right now. That's when I see it. So I guess about at the 50% point, but I've got a lot of games to play that I need to be writing about, and Overwatch is coming out next week, and basically I'm on the video game treadmill forever, so I can only play Dark Souls 3 on occasion.
Dima turning on Far Harbor? Now that would be cause for...
Thank you, Vodka. Thank you.
You don't trust Dima? After you came all this way for him?
I didn't come to Acadia for him. I came here because this place offered answers. And now that I've found a place I belong, I'd rather not lose it all if Dima is secretly planning to destroy everything.
I'll help if I can, but that's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop, but it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
Damn it. Should not have sent back what's-his-face. Nick, because he could have hacked the terminal for me. Maybe.
I'll figure this out. Just stay here.
Okay. Good luck, and come back as soon as you've found anything.
Whatever.
Yeah,
JBobo89.
I
hope there's a way to make some caps out of it.
Galaxy's pretty rad. Definitely worth checking out. On its various platforms. It's kind of a shame that it ended up flying under the radar. As for my typical day, my day is actually spent writing and doing like, and organizing and doing work. It's only after work that I usually,
won't be able to pick this.
Never got around to upgrading my lockpicking skills. Okay. So what is it I can do? Hack the terminal, gain access to the storage room, talk to Dima. I could always kill Dima. That would solve a lot of problems. Sometimes I have a chance to play a game, you know, during the... Sometimes I have a chance to play a game during the day, but mostly I play them in my off time.
You've seen a good bit of our island. What do you think?
Are you gonna kill me? Oh.
It's kind of beautiful.
That's refreshing. This island, with all of its danger and beauty, predates you, and it will continue to adapt. Long after.
That's cool.
And then, passing that knowledge.
That sounds like a noble.
Well, thank you. I should note that I'm not fully versed in human anatomy. But I'm your. Since Dima has a.
Never mind.
I'll get back to it then.
Okay, bye. Ooh, can I take some first aid? Yeah. Don't need any right away right now. So you're Faraday. That's the storage room. I guess Dima's upstairs. How do I get upstairs though? Here we go. Hello.
Dima?
What can I do for you?
Kasumi says she's seeing parts of your memories. Death projections. For Far Harbor and the center of the island.
That's unfortunate.
She should be focusing on herself, her new life. She shouldn't have to bear the burden of the outside world. Please, this is a matter best left to me and my advisors. We aren't planning to destroy the island. Those projections were merely to help us realize the cost of inaction.
Sounds like a lot of fancy talk aimed at throwing us off the trail. Must mean we're onto something.
I'm getting sick of this whole noble leader bullshit from you, Dima. Now stop hiding and tell me the truth.
All right. You've made your point. There's a conflict that's been brewing on this island shortly after we built Acadia. Between Far Harbor and the Children of Atom.
Simply put, they want to kill each other, and each side wants us to help them.
We've tried to stay neutral, but Far Harbor was going to be wiped out by the fog, so that's when we built the condensers for them.
What's wrong with your ears, man?
And I was friends with the previous leader of the Children of Atom, Confessor Martin. I even gave them their headquarters, the submarine base.
They have a submarine base?
The Nucleus.
Which was a mistake, because Martin is gone and the new Confessor, Tectus, is completely insane.
He's been threatening us, to force us to choose a side. I left behind something very important in that submarine base I gave them.
Dima's earliest memories are stored in the military computer banks in that base. The pre-war security systems and Confessor Martin's goodwill were supposed to keep them safe.
But now Tectus is in charge, and he's after Dima's memories. We don't even know what's in them.
But we do know that I spent nearly a century on this island alone. Whatever's in there is too dangerous to allow Tectus to get his hands on them.
I see. So what can I do to help?
If you're willing to retrieve what I've lost and bring my memories back to me, then we'd all be one step closer to solving this conflict without bloodshed.
You'll have to get through the Children of Atom's base. You're new on the island, so you might be able to pose as a recruit.
Then, once you get to the memory banks, you'll have to use a special program Dima and I have been working on to break through the security systems.
It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'll get your memories, Dima.
If we're lucky, the pre-war defenses have kept the Children of Atom at bay. But that means you'll have to get past them yourself. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the Children.
But I don't like them. They're ugly.
Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
Good.
I've got no love for those mindless fanatics. I won't complain if it comes to violence. Yeah, I'm hoping it does.
Okay, Longfellow. Thank you for your observations. Where are the stairs? The island. There we are. Ooh, bottle cap. I guess I'm gonna report into Kasumi now. Back and forth, talk to this person, talk to that person. Shoot some things.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the Children of Atom. He's afraid of what they're going to find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the Children of Atom will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind? Is there really something in them that's dangerous? Do you have a way in? Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the Children of Atom, of course.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima...
Really? How would that work? when I was taking a peek in the computers he has, I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does. I'll bet that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it?
She's totally chilling with the Atom.
I'll keep an eye on things here.
I'll get Dima's memories.
Good luck.
Oh, money. Okay. Let's go do things. Let's go explore. Oh, I need to go upstairs. I don't like the layout of this place. It's dark and... How do I turn on... See, that's running. It's jumping. Map. Gun. Can't remember how to turn on my stupid headlamp. Oh. Oops. Maybe it's the D-pad. I'm trying to remember how to turn on my headlamp. No. Okay, Longfellow. Whatever you say. See, if I just keep telling him that, he'll just, you know, he won't kill me. I'm kind of convinced that Longfellow's like my drunk uncle. Longfellow's like Trump 2016 all the way. Oh, hold down O? That makes sense. Thank you, Internet Technique. You teach me internet techniques. Oh, there we go. It's been a while since I've played Fallout 4. Whee! Alright. Where to next, Phil? Phil, read the map! Yeah, I'll do that later. I'm gonna go kill some people now. So yeah, that gives you a taste of the story. Whoa, this is like way south. Like the bottom of the map. Let's see, where is... Okay, Far Harbor's here. I'm here. So basically I gotta hit like super south. Like crazy south. But still, that might be fun, a fun way to end the stream. Let's just take a walk. A long walk. Very long walk. Crazy how big the world in this game is. This is all DLC too. I don't know if you guys saw it, but there was a pretty amazing Let's Play recently where somebody beat Fallout 4. They couldn't die. They did it without dying, and they were playing on like super survival mode. And for whatever reason, they managed to accidentally turn Preston Garvey, who into like an eternal hostile, essentially. And so Preston was always trying to follow them around and kill them, except that Preston was their companion. So Preston was always warping to where they were. Sorry, whatever you are. Yao Guai. bear thing. Oh, poor bear. Okay, that was all me, man. I did that. I shot the bear. You did not shoot the bear. I shot the bear. See ya, Jay Bobo. Thanks for coming around. And if you enjoyed the stream, go ahead and subscribe. We actually stream quite a bit lately. Stream minimum twice a week. And Jeremy is also doing his Mega Manathon right now, where he's playing through, I think, every Mega Man game, like, made between the original Mega Man and Mega Man Legends 2. He just played Mega Man 2 for the Game Boy. So yeah, he's even doing the Game Boy games. Unfortunately, Jeremy's laptop is dead right now. So he's not able to do a lot. Hopefully he'll get his laptop back soon and he can get back to streaming and making videos for Game Boy World and all that. In the meantime, I think Bob is doing a stream tomorrow, actually, for Dungeon Keeper. And then we'll continue on next week. Oh, I've leveled up. Sweet. What should I get? I could kind of use intelligence. More intelligence? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Yeah. I want all of the research or science. And rank 3 for that. Great. Now I can continue to upgrade my guns. Keep crafting them. But yeah, so as you know, we're doing a video podcast right now called From Us to You. It is on, you can find them on our YouTube channel. There are also an audio version on SoundCloud. And yeah, so you should go and get those. The reason I bring them up is because I'd like to do a live version, and if we do, we'll totally put them on this Twitch channel, and you can come hang out with us while we talk about video games. It'll be sweet. And we will. So yeah, you should subscribe to us for those reasons too. I've learned a lot about streaming in the past couple years. Hell, it helps that the tools have gotten more sophisticated, but I think streaming's an art form. I'm not saying that I'm the best streamer ever or anything, but I'm definitely a lot better than I was a couple years ago. Wow, okay. Oh. I seem to have walked right into, like, Trapper Central here. I'm basically the Terminator right now. Poor Trappers. Yeah, that's nice of them. Did you mess up my leg? That's not cool. Oh no, my leg's fine. That was just your blood. But in all seriousness, I thought your armor was pretty cool, dead guy. Oh, am I still being shot at? Can I, like, have it? Harpoon? Yeah, I want that. Yeah. about you? Can I have anything from you? Stim pack? Cool. Lobster trap helmet? No. Terminating, burninating through the countryside. Seems like kind of a bad idea to just jump in there. Maybe I need to go up. I mean, normally I'd be all for it, but also, I probably should rest. Oh, legendary. Where are you? Hello, legendary guy. Frustrated grunt. Okay. Are you in here? There we go. You dead. Ow. Eh, sure, why not? So it seems like so far, Far Harbor is another, like, it adds even more factions, essentially. I wonder if I'll have to destroy all of them, or if, I wonder if I'll have to destroy the ones I don't side with. Oh my god. Come on. Oh, that was a waste of ammo. Okay, so where do I go? Okay, this way, I guess. Hey, Rallo. Nope, From Us to You is back! You should re-subscribe to the podcast. Tell your friends. From Us, our flagship podcast is here. It's both an audio and video format. You can find it on our YouTube channel. You can find it on the original podcast feed. Sorry for the long absence, but we kind of had to figure out what we wanted to do with it. Some of it was just to do with the fact that we needed somebody to take point on it, and I wasn't super interested in hosting both of them, both the RPG podcast and the flagship podcast, because, I just don't want them to both sound the same, is what it kind of comes down to. So From Us to You works because we're doing it on a rotating basis, though I still do all the work. But that's okay. I don't mind doing all the work in the background. And it gives me a chance to kind of get better at video editing in particular. I'm learning a lot. So yeah, it's been fun. Also, I don't know if I'm pointed north or south. I assume this is, I'm heading south now. No? Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna turn and see. Oh yeah, so I'm that arrow. I'll marry you, Longfellow. Actually, no, I won't. Vote Trump. My favorite part of any Bethesda game is these parts where you're just walking through these massive worlds, exploring, discovering things. Wow, that sky is green. There's always so much to find in a Bethesda game. Their worlds are so packed with stuff. I assume that I'm in, like, Radiation Town right now. But that's fine, because I am wearing my sweet power armor. Ooh, what's this? Oh, Alpha Deathclaw. Spectre, you're up. Yeah, Seven Pains. I never finished Skyrim. I got like halfway through the main quest, but the last time I played it, I was busy turning myself into a werewolf. There's just so much to do and find and enjoy in any given Bethesda game that it just seems like a waste to go to Critical Path and go straight through the main story. And often the main story is kind of the weakest part anyway. Though I did actually like Fallout 4's main story. I thought it was pretty good, actually. I liked the mystery of the Institute. That. Okay, wow, I don't know what that is. Okay, that's not doing a lot of damage. Crap. He breathes fire or something? Are you even, like, doing any damage to him, Longfellow? Did you get him? Jeez. That guy was annoying.
than someone else.
Dang, my HP is actually kind of low. Where are my stim packs? Ooh, ice cold beer. There we go. Anyhow, I think we're almost there. Here we go. Yeah, there's a lot of guys to kill. Okay. God for this Admiral's gun. Does double damage if they have full health. So I think it's just gonna let me kill everybody. Except Longfellow's helping. Stop helping, Longfellow. Oh no, my arm's damaged. You know how annoying it is to repair my friggin' power armor? Let me give you a hint. Really annoying. Seriously? Okay. Oh my god. Who are you? What? Explosions in this game. What the heck is a rad chicken? Oh, it's literally a chicken? Is it an evil chicken? Why is it showing as an enemy?
Run while you can.
Did you notice that, like, all of your people are dead? Like, your friends are all dead. You don't have a head anymore. So I'm like wearing power armor and you're not. Granted, it's slightly dinged power armor at this point. Where are you? Where are you, precious? Come on. I'm looking for you. I know you're here somewhere. Are you all the way upstairs? I suppose so. Hi! Bye, Douglas. Sweet. This mysterious holotape. Let's find out. And it was the lady all along.
Well, that settles it. I am 100% screwed. Damn this fog. You'd think a lighthouse would be easy to find, but not this. Never seen fog like it. Get talked into this. How do I know that woman wasn't crazy? I'm starting to think her whole story was some fantasy she cooked up to get attention. Taking out one trapper to avenge her husband's death. Sounded easy enough. Now I wish I'd stayed far away from this godforsaken island. Shit, something's coming.
Hehe. I knew it. Whoa. Oh, neat. Can I, like, have this place? Caught some of my boys trying to steal some of the loot and took off that traitor. Had to put a bullet in him to show the others, just in the leg for now. Pulled all the stuff in the trunk and dropped in one of the fishing nets. I'll hang on to the key. Oh, okay. Take that. I need a nap. Ooh, it's all sweaty and gross. Okay, HP is full. Good to me. Cooking stove. Hope you don't mind me just poking around this lighthouse a little longer. This is like the second lighthouse that has been like full of doom. Let's see, bottle cap, sniper rifle? I don't need a sniper rifle. I already got a killer sniper rifle. Here.
Look alive.
What's he?
Look alive.
Swapping supplies.
Yeah. So I already got a plasma sniper rifle. It's actually not too bad. More fun than the plasma rifle. Much lower fire rate, though. and lower range and lower accuracy. Oh wait. Yeah. But more damage. Eh. I need my 308 ammo for my tactical 308 combat rifle. I'm sure there's more stuff to find. One of the fishing nets. I'll come back for it later. In the meantime, I'm gonna go talk to the crazy lady and get my reward. Maybe I'll have to kill her. That'd be nice. Anyway.
I'm sorry, but
man, it's always rainy here. Never stops raining.
General supplies? Debate shop.
What kind of person just shoots a man for sport? All those trappers can burn in hell.
That trapper who killed your husband is dead.
You take your time, killing that trapper. Make it hurt. The way I've been hurting since I lost my dad.
That trapper who killed your husband is dead.
Then it's done. It's finally done. All those lives that were lost, all those debts finally repaid. And it was no son or daughter of Far Harbor who stood up to the island and avenged the Dalton bloodline. It was you, an outsider, a mainlander. The final chapter's been written. The story has come to an end. This is a day I never thought I'd live to see. Thank you.
I've been to Holotape, the last guy you sent to the lighthouse. He thought your whole story was a lie. Is it?
A lie? No, no. It was true. Or at least there was truth in it. Was there a little harmless exaggeration as well? Perhaps. But some things are more important than truth. Look at you, for instance. You've seen the island's dangers and survived. You've learned something valuable. What's more, the island learned something too. It knows.
Why am I in Lost all of a sudden?
Back mainlander who can't tell up from down in the fog. The island will respect you now.
So basically a smoke monster is going to show up soon.
I'm less interested in your family revenge story than I am in getting paid.
I see. Well, you're a stranger to our island. Can't expect you to really understand what's important here. Now every good story's got to have a happy ending, right? The hero finds the treasure, saves the sweetheart, and rides off into the sunset. Well, I'm a little old to leap up on a horse. But I have got something close to a treasure. This is an heirloom that's been in my family.
I like heirlooms.
For at least a generation or two. There's no Daltons left to inherit the thing. So it might as well pass on to you. The island knows this weapon. Oh, yes. You carry this?
Yeah, but Uncharted 4 isn't an open world game on the same scale as Fallout 4.
I can sleep easy now.
If they could have pulled off Uncharted 4's graphics in Fallout 4, I think it would have been the technical accomplishment of the, like, an all-time technical achievement. I think it looks pretty darn good, all things considered. A hook? Gave me a friggin' hook? I mean, it's kind of an awesome hook. And I'm tempted to give it to Longfellow, because it'll be funny. In fact, I think I will. Longfellow!
Longfellow knows what he's about.
Yes, stabbing people with hooks.
Fresh shipment. All your medical and
food. This is ridiculous. Guns, you're guns. In
charge. There you are, Longfellow. I have a present for you.
Hmm?
It's a big hook. The blood letter. What did I do with it? Oh, that explains it. Equip. There. It's funny to have you have a hook. And on that note, there you go. There you go, Longfellow. That's exactly how it should be. And on that note, that is the end of my stream. Thanks so much for coming and listening with me. You can find the archived version of this on our YouTube channel. Check out From Us to You, which has returned. And also check out Acts of the Blood God, my RPG podcast. We have a new episode going up tomorrow. And I think we're going to be streaming again tomorrow as well. Probably Dungeon Keeper, so keep an eye out for that. In any case, I've been Cat Bailey. Thanks for dropping by on our stream. Keep checking back. If you enjoyed the stream, subscribe, tell your friends. Really appreciate it. In the meantime, talk to you later. Bye-bye.